So regular listeners to the Matthew Filipowicz Show know we actually cover the issue of net neutrality a good deal here on the show. And there actually was some news late last week when it comes to net neutrality. There was some news in the fight for a free and open internet. If you are not familiar, net neutrality is the concept that all internet communications should be treated the same, that there should not be a fast lane and a slow lane on the internet, that giant companies can't pay more to get their content delivered faster, that internet service providers, telecom companies like Comcast or AT&T or Verizon can't speed up content, they can't slow down content, they can't block content, they must treat all internet traffic the same. That is what the concept is, that all internet traffic must be treated equally. It's the core concept of net neutrality. It is the core tenet of internet freedom, which has made the internet the amazing tool that it is for today, be it for business, be it for activism, you name it. The internet is the internet because all content is treated the same. Now, you may remember months ago, the FCC, the Federal Communications Commission, and its chairman, Tom Wheeler, proposed rules that would, in fact, gut net neutrality, would kill the open internet as we know it. After these possible rules were announced, people responded. So many people responded that they crashed the FCC's servers. Literally millions spoke out in opposition to the proposed rule change that was going through. And, you know, all the while, the FCC chairman, Tom Wheeler, kept saying that he believes in net neutrality, even while his proposal would kill it. That he was, you know, saying one thing, doing another. He thought that people weren't paying attention to what he was actually proposing, but obviously we were. So according to, and so there was an enormous outcry to his proposed plan against it here. So the Wall Street Journal has a report on supposedly a new net neutrality proposal that's being considered, and I regret to tell you, the new proposal is still bloody horrible. I'm reading from the Wall Street Journal, quote, "The plan now under consideration would separate broadband into two distinct services, a retail one, which consumers would pay broadband providers for internet access, and a back-end one, in which broadband providers serve as the conduit for websites to distribute content," end quote. All right, I know that sounds a little wonky here. So under this new hybrid net, air quotes, net neutrality plan here, the front end would theoretically, the back end, sorry, would be regulated under Title II of the Communications Act, which is what, which, by the way, having net neutrality regulated under Title II is what all types of net neutrality activists and internet freedom activists and advocates have been asking for the entire internet. They want the entire internet to be regulated under Title II. We want the whole internet reclassified under Title II. And supposedly, this plan would just do that for half of it, leaving the other half not regulated by Title II, leaving the other half to be still able to be screwed with by these corporations. So the New York Times has an explanation. The New York Times explains, quote, "It would apply utility-like regulation to the wholesale portion in the exchange of data from content provider to the internet service provider for passage through to the end consumer. The retail portion, the transaction that sends data through internet service provider to the consumer and which allows the consumer to access any legal content on the internet, would receive a lighter regulatory touch," end quote. So despite this again, him again using the language and calling it net neutrality, it's still not a real net neutrality. According to our friends, our good friends over at Free Press, which you can find at freepress.net, which we have on all the time. According to Free Press, this plan would, quote, "allow broadband providers to cut specialized deals with companies to reach internet users and still gives us slow lanes and gives users no real protection against discrimination from internet service providers," end quote. That's the bottom line. It still creates fast lanes and slow lanes on the internet. It still changes the internet as we know it. It still kills net neutrality. And this is maddening. This is maddening. You know, Free Press called this correctly a Frankenstein plan, you know, piecing together this sort of monster plan. And again, this is another instance, excuse me, where clearly the FCC thinks that we're still not bloody paying attention, that we're still not looking at the actual details. And again, we haven't gotten all the details on this, but just the fact that they're trying to split this in two, they're saying they're splitting the baby in half, right, is still insane. Craig Aaron back at Free Press said in a statement, quote, "The FCC is supposed to protect our communications, period. Chairman Wheeler can't wave a wand, change the law, and pretend to break the internet in two. These schemes suggest just that, dividing the internet to protect corporations sending information, but not the people receiving it. Such an untested, too clever by half approach is bad law and a bad idea. It will not survive in court, and it is clearly inferior to reclassifying broadband under Title II of the Communications Act," end quote. And look, you know, reading about the whole thing, what it is, a lot of people, reporters, are saying that the FCC and Chairman Wheeler are just trying to come up with a compromise. They're just trying to compromise. That, and compromise is always good, right? You know, they want to find something that makes both the internet service providers, the telecom companies happy, and the consumers. But look, again, this is another one of those instances, folks, that there really is no compromise. There is no compromise on this. When one side of this argument, the big telecom companies, the ISPs, think of like Comcast, when one side wants to create fast and slow lanes, when one side wants to kill the internet as we know it, there's no compromise here. There's no, hey, why don't we meet them halfway here? There's no compromise. And that is what the stupid, horrible FCC is trying to do. Literally snapping the internet and breaking it in two. And the FCC still thinks they can use net neutrality language and think we're not going to notice. They still think we're not paying attention. The good news is, supposedly this is one of four possible plans being floated around the FCC. And who knows what they're actually going to end up proposing. But this is the deal here, folks. Take a minute and send a message to the FCC. It takes like 30 seconds to do. Free Press has a petition. You can get it at freepress.net, or we'll link to it at matthewf.net. Send a message to FCC Chairman Wheeler. Tell him we're paying attention. Tell him when it comes to net neutrality, there is no bloody compromise. Demand a free and open internet with no fast lanes and slow lanes here. Demand true net neutrality. Again, you can do that by going to freepress.net, or we'll link to it at matthewf.net. We'll be right back.